When the firehouse bell rang across the countryside, the volunteer firefighters responded. Even if there wasn't a fire.
Okay, George, I think everyone has heard it. You want to get the siren, George? What a doozy of a turnout for this year's Fireman's Muster Games. I hope everyone has been practicing hose and ladder work.
I must have climbed up and down to my treehouse 100 times.
Excellent. As you know, each year our town volunteer firemen face a different squad in games that test individual skills and teamwork.
And each year, something goes wrong and we lose.
George remembered that at last year's muster, things did go wrong. And got very wet.
But if we stay focused, maybe this year we'll win that trophy.
Hooray!
Oh, you got it! Oh, kids.
Looks like this year's opponents are here.
Hi, everyone.
Well, look at that.
George couldn't believe it. It was his friends from the city. Rescue Squad 86. Even Blaze.
All right. There are 3 games. Allie here will keep score. The team with the most points at the end wins the trophy. Our first game is a test of teamwork and strength. The fruit and veggie wash. Each team must build up enough pressure in these antique water pumpers to hit their red or yellow targets.
That looks kind of challenging.
Very challenging.
Is this fair? Our team has more people.
No. The number of people on your team isn't as important as how you work together. The key is teamwork.
Captains, are your teams ready?
Ready!
Go!
Other side! Oh my gosh, we need people on the other side! No! Not everybody! You 4 on that side! Everyone else over here! That's it! Now pull for your lives! Quick! Faster! Steady, Rudolph team! Steady!
The red team wins!
Aw, fiddlesticks.
Our bucket brigade takes teamwork and coordination. Fill your buckets, pass them down the line, and empty them down there into your trough. The first team with a full trough wins.
Wanna try it, George? Full fire buckets are really heavy.
When you know big stars, even small big stars, you sometimes get invited to private rehearsals.
Ooh-hee.
And you can bring your friends.
Come up and say hi if you want to.
Great show, Mr. Teckle. Amazing.
Just need to paint the ramps and we're ready for tonight.
I'd be happy to help if you like.
Me too. Anything for a fellow dachshund lover.
That's right kind of you. I'll need a place to keep my dogs. Can't have paint-spattered pups.
You want to look after them, George?
Terrific! Here are their leashes if you want to take them for a walk.
We'll be back to get them before showtime tonight, okay?
No wonder the dogs were so skilled. They never stopped practicing. Though some parts of the act still needed work. An apartment was no place for rehearsals. If only George knew a spot where dachshunds stayed calm and quiet. He did. The lobby. It was the perfect wiener dog habitat. But how could he keep them there? Maybe that old gate could help. Hundley was amazed. The monkey had created a wiener wonderland. The doxies had run out of water. Hundley was happy to have his guests enjoy the entire lobby. If only they would stay there. They had to get those doxies back. But first, George wanted to know how many he needed to catch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 leashes in all, which meant they had to find 8 missing dogs. But where would all those performing dogs go?
No, please, thank you, friends. I've never sold so many melons.
Hundley didn't want the doxies to run off again. What luck! It was a big crate. Even performing doxies couldn't escape from there. 1, 2, 3. Summer days seem to last forever. You need a lot of ideas to fill them up. Like playing jingle bells on a squeaky hinge.
Ruff. face it, George. We'll never get to Jingle All the Way.
That's me, all right, at the bucket toss at the old country fair when I was a kid. If you tossed a bean bag in a bucket, you got points. And the bucket.
Ah! Oh, I remember.
Oh, that's a dunk booth. Doesn't get better than a dunk booth.
You mean hitting the bullseye and dunking some poor guy into the water?
No, being that guy. What's more fun than getting dunked in a tank of cool water on a hot summer day?
Never thought of it that way.
But not that I know. I never did get dunked, but I always wanted to be.
And there it was. One bona fide, fun-filled, terrific idea for a summer afternoon.
You want to make our own fair, George? That's a great idea.
Okay, let us know if there's anything we can do.
Just need more buckets.
Hi, George. Are those for your fare? Okay, great. Wonder where he got all that stuff. Oh.
Five, 10, 15, 20, 25. Here, see how many points you can get, George.
What you doing?
We're building our own country fair.
No kidding! Hey, what about a boat race? I saw one at Sprouts Camp.
Ahoy! All hands on deck! Aye, aye, Captain!
Hey! Oh, sure, of course. I was just, you know, cleaning them. Wouldn't want dirty bath toys. Wow, looks like your fair has turned into a big project.
Water? Check. Boats for the boat race? Check. Making them go? No idea. Maybe we should forget the hose idea.
It was a perfect day in the country for a hike. Some places in the country were hard to reach. They were worth it.
Good hiking for a city kid, George.
We're almost there.
The super secret, hidden, nobody but us knows about it view.
Hey, I'm getting hungry. Sandwich break? I can walk on my leg, George. Aww. Maybe if I go slow. Ouch! That's not going to work.
George knew he needed to go for help.
Hey, thanks for the lift, guys.
You did a great job getting help for your friend, George.
I called your mom, Bill. She's gonna meet you at the hospital.
You know, I'm actually looking forward to going there.
You are?
Yeah. They have the best fruit cup I've ever tasted. It almost makes all this worth it.
Hey, George. Would you like to ride in the ambulance with us?
Sure, why not?
Paramedic's job to give people first aid and bring them to the hospital, George.
Right. And the ambulance has all the equipment we need. It's almost like a rolling hospital.
Hey, Danny. Hey, Nurse Paula. How's it going, Barry? Hi, Trish.
Wow. You seem to know a lot of people here.
Yeah, I've been in the hospital before. Oh, yeah. Broke my arm playing chess. Met everybody.
Well, hello, Bill. What happened?
Hurt my leg.
What was it this time? Checkers?
Turkey sandwich. It's a wristband for the doctors and nurses to keep track of all of us patients.
Well, Bill, it looks like your leg is broken in 3 places.
Really?
Bill's leg looked like it was all in one piece.
You can't see the break on the outside. That's why we radiologists use an X-ray machine. It takes pictures of how you look on the inside.
George had seen an X-ray before.
That's right. There are fractures here, here, and here. What happened?
Slipped on a turkey sandwich.
Of course. I should have guessed.
George thought he'd like to have an X-ray machine of his own.
Looks like Bill's gonna need a cast so his leg can heal.
It was the last day of the year, which meant George was busy putting up decorations.
Uh-oh. Streamers get away from you again, George?
After decorating, there was baking and preparing for guests.
Looks like we're all set for New Year's. You're right, George. Tomorrow starts the brand new year. Which means we'll need a new calendar.
Ooh,
We'll tear off the last number at midnight, and you know what happens then.
Yeah.
Happy New Year! Hey, you think you can really stay up till midnight this year, George? Well, if you want to be awake at midnight, it might help to take a nap. Okay, your choice, but you might fall asleep and miss the party like last year.
George didn't want to miss the party. So he decided to give the nap a try. But it was too bright to sleep. Finally, George was ready to fall asleep.
George, what are you... Trouble sleeping, huh? You know what my grandmother used to tell me? If you can't sleep, count sheep. Give it a try. You'll be asleep in no time.
One. George needed to count more than one sheep to get sleepy. Luckily, he knew just where to find some. The sheep kept moving. George couldn't tell which ones he'd counted. If George wanted to know how many sheep there were, he could only count each sheep once. So he asked the sheep to line up. Getting sheep to follow directions was harder than George expected. If only sheep came with numbers.
George, I thought you were taking a nap. Okay, have fun with our calendar.
Now George could number the sheep as he counted them. Sheep number one was very friendly. Little monkeys love riding buses. But a ride on the Z-Bus was the best trip of all. Because it ended at...
Welcome to Zany Island. Say hello to our new friends, Petey.
Hello.
How would you like your own, Petey?
Wow, nice, George.
There'll be adventure ahead. And here's a map to keep you on course. Have fun.
George planned on having a great time. And thanks to his map, he wouldn't miss a thing. Fred rode fast rides, slow rides, scary rides, wet rides, and scenic rides. Until one by one, George, Petey, and the man with the yellow hat had ridden them all.
Too bad they don't come in yellow.
Lucky you! You got the last one in your size. We're usually out of stock by this time of day.
Oh. Avast, mateys! That be your warning shot. Zany Island be cruising in 30 minutes, I say.
One more ride? Did you have a good time today, George? What was your favorite part? Yeah, you sure had fun with Petey. Huh? Hey, where is Petey? Did we leave him behind? I know you're worried about Petey, but it's really late. I promise, we'll look for him first thing in the morning, okay?
But George didn't want to wait until morning. Luckily, he didn't have to. The Z bus ran all night. He could rescue Petey now. Zany Island was a big place. Good thing George had kept his map. It showed everywhere he and Petey had been that day. Let the hunt for Parrot Petey begin. But George wondered where to look first. Maybe right here.